The radio link test can be used to verify the radio link quality between two modules. This test application measures the packet error rate by counting the number of transmitted and received packets in the locally connected device and peer device. The direction from local to peer device is called downlink. For every received downlink packet, a corresponding uplink packet is expected. The peer device counts the number of received and transmitted packets and returns this status back to the local device. Finally, the local device sends a status message to the PC, which contains the packet counters and further status information about the downlink and uplink channel quality. Downlink and uplink status. Transmitted packets is the number of RF packets transmitted between local device and peer device. Received packets are the number of received packets. Packet error rate, PER, is 100 times 1 minus received packets divided by transmitted packets. Peer RSSI is the received signal strength on peer device. Peer SNR is the measured SNR at the peer device. To conduct the radio link test, both radio modules must be programmed to the same RF parameters. RF parameters can be set under the configuration menu. If you want to change the RF parameters, you must do this in both radio modules. Therefore, connect both radio modules with the PC and configure the same radio settings. Please note that both radio modules must be set to RX always on. To permanently write the RF settings, please switch on the store in non-volatile memory option. Now you can disconnect the peer device from your PC and switch the power supply of the peer device to the battery using switch S1. The peer device is ready to conduct the radio link test. Now you can choose some test-specific parameters on the radio link test application page with your local device. Destination group address and destination device address, which should match with the address of the peer device. RF packet size, number of packets to be sent in one test cycle. Infinite test option determines if the test should be repeated automatically. Before you start the radio link test, it is recommended to use the option Log Data. With this option, you log all relevant information into a file. Upon hitting Start, the test configuration is sent to the local device. The transmission of the radio test packets and its timing is now controlled by the firmware itself. As expected, for every received downlink packet, there is a corresponding uplink packet. You can now take the peer device to the dedicated place. When you finish your test, you can close the log file and import it into Microsoft Excel to get a writable file.